SwitchBot have very kindly sent me their SwitchBot blind tilt gadget to have a play with, but in order to show you this, I'm going to need to show you behind the scenes here. So let's turn off the green screen background. In fact, I'm going to have to remove this green screen altogether. Let's open this blind. Hey Siri, open the study blinds. Look, vertical blinds controlled by Apple HomeKit. Let me show you how I did that. The SwitchBot Blind Tilt is a clever little robot that wraps itself around the wand used to adjust the tilt of your blinds. It's actually designed for Venetian blinds, that's the horizontal ones, and it adjusts the tilt of the blind slats. But I don't have any Venetian blinds, I've got vertical blinds. Okay, old and tatty vertical blinds, but I like the way that they let light in even when fully closed, so I get privacy and a bit of natural light from them. Officially, according to the SwitchBot FAQ, the blind tilt does not support vertical blinds. This is understandable, seeing as most vertical blinds are not wand controlled, and also if you open the tilt more than halfway, then the slats are just going to hit the robot. Well, I saw that as more of a challenge than a restriction. I managed to hack my vertical blinds to support wand control, which means I could then attach the blind tilt. I'll show you later on how I actually did that, but let's talk about the SwitchBot blind tilt itself first. As well as the blind tilt, SwitchBot also sent me their Hub Mini and a little remote. Now here's the thing, if you have Home Assistant and your hardware supports Bluetooth, like on a Raspberry Pi 4, then you don't actually need that hub, because the blind tilt will connect straight to Home Assistant really easily. There are some limitations with that, which I'll go over when I show you how to set it up, but the hub itself does have some neat features worthy of a video in its own right. If you don't use Home Assistant, then for starters, you're probably watching the wrong video, but also you might find that the hub is a lot more useful for automating the blind tilt. Unboxing the tilt was a bit like unpacking a Lego set. There are so many pieces, but don't worry, just follow their installation video and it's actually a lot easier to install than you might think. Oh, and there's a solar panel to keep the battery topped up too. So I got it all installed and working on my study blind, and it took me a few days to get the parts I needed from eBay to make the conversion to wand control, but I didn't film any of it for some reason. Fortunately, SwitchBot sent me two of them. We have more vertical blinds in our living room, so I'm going to take you into that room now and show you how I converted them. Here are some more vertical blinds. You can see here we've got a control for operating the tilt using this beaded cord, and then this thin cord here opens and closes the blinds themselves. Now the idea is we want to fit a little adapter right inside the mechanism here to control the tilt. Now the first thing we need to do, of course, is take down all of the blinds so as we can get the mechanism down and start adjusting the rail. The blind rail down, and I need to install this little gadget. I'll put a link to this in the description, and it's got to go inside this rail right here. Let me give you a bit of a close-up here. You see these little holes here are where the strings run through for the blinds, so I need to actually cut those little bits out so as the strings can run through without me having to undo the whole string inside the rail. Let me just snip those out. The next job is to open this thing up. So inside this mechanism you can see this little metal nut on the end. I've got to take that off, pull this whole wheel off, and get access to this part just here. A little plastic spacer inside that's going to be cut up a little bit, because we're going to put this adapter kind of in the middle of where it used to be, so I need to chop that up a little bit. So I've got some scissors. I want to chop up a quarter of the way down, and then a quarter off the other end, and the middle half we don't need anymore. Put the quarter on there. going to fit the mechanism onto the rail now. There we go. Once you've got it back together again, it's got to go back on the window. Okay, so the very last part is to attach the wand to the mechanism. So let's slide that in up here. Right, so if I can show you, it goes in just like that. Now if I twist it, it opens the tilt of the blinds. Twist it the other way and it closes them. Okay, so maybe converting blinds is not for everyone, but it wasn't the hardest DIY job I've ever done. You can now install the blind tilt and connect to it using the SwitchBot app. So the next part, Home Assistant. Well, it's really very easy if you have Bluetooth enabled on your Home Assistant server, which you probably do by default if you have it running on a Raspberry Pi, like I said before. For me at least, the SwitchBot blind tilt just appeared as a discovered device. All you need to do is go to Settings, Devices and Services, and find the discovered blind tilt and click on Configure, Submit and Finish. That's it. I know this one here is my study blind tilt, so I'm going to rename this study blind tilt. I can then just add that study control straight to the dashboard and view it here. It's possibly one of the easiest installations ever, but there's a catch. This is Bluetooth and range is going to be a bit limited. If your blinds are not within Bluetooth range of your Home Assistant server, then it won't work. Well, there's a workaround and it's called a Bluetooth proxy. There's an add-on for Home Assistant called ESP Home. It basically lets you really easily create your own devices and sensors and connect them over Wi-Fi to Home Assistant. You might have seen some of my other videos about this where I create a lot of fan controllers. Well, if you use what's called an ESP32 microcontroller, you can configure it as a Bluetooth proxy device. Place it near your Bluetooth devices, it'll connect to your Wi-Fi network and relay those Bluetooth signals over Wi-Fi back to Home Assistant. Genius! I happen to already have an ESP32 device sitting in my lounge because it runs the fan inside my AV cabinet. So I updated its configuration to support Bluetooth proxy service too. I'm not going to go over how to configure a Bluetooth proxy device in this video because there are already loads of tutorials out there. Check out the one from Mostly Chris if you want to take a look at this, and I'll put a link to that video in the description. So now you have your vertical blinds converted to use a wand and your fancy SwitchBot tilt all set up in Home Assistant. But wouldn't it be nice to be able to ask Siri to control your blinds? Of course it would. If you don't yet have Home Assistant connected to Apple HomeKit, follow the instructions in this video, which I'll put a link to in the description. Once you've got that up and running, come back here. Now, as with most things Apple Home, we're gonna need to fudge things a bit. HomeKit doesn't understand blind tilts. It only understands opening and closing. That means we can't just take the tilt entity from Home Assistant and pass it to HomeKit. On the SwitchBot page of Home Assistant's website, there's an example proxy template entity that wraps the tilt control and places it in a normal open-close blind entity. But I found that it didn't work well for me because even though if the tilt is fully open, it's supposed to report a position of 50, sometimes it reports any value between 45 and 50. So using that configuration, it frequently failed to show as open. Of course, I have an alternative. You'll need to edit your configuration.yaml file. I suggest you go to the add-on store, which is in Settings. You can click on that little blue button, search for File Editor, click on Install. Okay, once it's installed, toggle the little option to show in sidebar and click on Start. You should be able to go to the File Editor menu option now, and then when that opens, it's by default in the configuration.yaml file, but just in case it isn't, you click on this little button here and click on configuration.yaml just there. Now scroll down to the bottom and find an empty section and paste in this little bit of configuration. Now I'll put a copy of this on my website for you and there'll be a link to that in the description, of course. Make sure that the cover entity that's mentioned several times here is the actual tilt entity that you have added to Home Assistant. You can also customize the name here and here if you want. Save the configuration, jump on over to Developer Tools, check that it's all okay. And if you've added template entities before, you should see template entities in this list here, or you can restart just to kick it into life. I should now be able to jump over to Settings, Devices and Services and Entities and search for Study Blind Tilt Wrapper here. And you can see I have now got Study Blind Tilt Wrapper. I can add that to my dashboard just here. Study Blind Tilt Wrapper. And let's just grab that full entity ID here. cover.studyblindtiltwrapper. Just copy that to the clipboard. Go back to File Editor, and we're going to find the HomeKit section here, which if you don't have your HomeKit section, then you haven't followed the HomeKit installation guide. So go check out that video first, and then you just paste the cover entity into this list. Click on Save. And back down to Developer Tools, just check the configuration again, and we should be able to reload just HomeKit. Over in iOS on your iPhone or iPad, you should now be able to see that the Study Blind wrapper has appeared in your default room. If I just edit this particular accessory, I should be able to assign it to my study. There we go. And open or close it. I know I was sent these for review by SwitchBot, but I've looked at the prices and they're not that expensive for what they are, really. Solar powered, compatible with Home Assistant, an open API if you want to go down that route. I have mine now automated using Home Assistant to open in the mornings when I start work and close again at sunset, which is great because I was always forgetting to close them in the evening. They can even be triggered by an away from home routine that you might have to help make your house look more lived in while you're away. The one thing they're missing though is the ability to fully open or close your blinds. If SwitchBot released such a product, then combined with the tilt, it would be an amazing full control solution for your blinds. Rumour has it SwitchBot are looking into a product like this, but there's nothing confirmed yet. If I ever get hold of something suitable to control the cords on the blind, then you can be certain there'll be another video. But for now, if you found this video useful, then please give it a like and don't forget to subscribe to my channel to see more from me. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.